female mayor who's taking on corruption and violence in Iraq. This and other stories at ozy.com/NPR. That's ozy.com.
Good afternoon. From WRBO, I'm Martha Donner. It's 4:04. New York State is preparing for the arrival of Hurricane Joaquin, with officials saying that while the storm's path remains uncertain, previous storms show it's best to prepare well in advance. Governor Andrew Cuomo tells reporters that the state is already moving equipment, including generators and pumps, into position, while state emergency officials watch the storm's progress. The Democratic governor says upgrades and repairs made after Superstorm Sandy and Hurricane Irene have made New York and New York City better prepared for the next tropical storm. A second pool while in Syracuse yesterday. The state was invested $100,000 in Syracuse Express, a company that transports people from Syracuse to New York City. The funds will be used to buy two 14-seat buses that will bring people in low to moderate income neighborhoods to workforce training centers. Google says that while jobs are coming back to Upstate,
people still can't get to jobs. So finding those jobs is important, but also finding infrastructure and transportation opportunities for them is important.
Syracuse Express will plug in the Syracuse Model Neighborhood Facility. The legal aid clinic for military veterans at Syracuse University College of Florida has taken on dozens of appeals from denied benefits and less than honorable discharges. The free clinic was established by two graduates and began paying for awaiting records from the Veterans Administration and service branches. Most clients are from Upstate New York, though it's open to any veteran. For more regional news coverage, visit WRBO.org. Weather for tonight, Valley County skies.